We, I believe, are live. Can you wave hello to everybody?
Hello!
The other hand, Carmen. I am going to just hold on here for a little bit to let everybody join. I'm not sure if we've got chat messages, but by all means, maybe I can open that up really quick. If anybody's receiving this, getting this, chat should work. But I'm going to let this all kind of get out there for a second. Facebook seems to be online. We'll wait for YouTube and LinkedIn and all the other good places out there. If you're on LinkedIn or... Hi, Jody. Yvette's Creations, hello there. Truth and Coffee, so exciting. Hello, hello, everyone. LinkedIn is in the building. It just says LinkedIn user, so I'm going to have to maybe have you type in your name so we know exactly who it is. Claudette, hello. Gloria, hello. Facebook seems to be definitely in the mix. Mr. Ashley Eiserhoff from Mistissini, hello, kind sir. Mr. Brad Bauman, LinkedIn is up and running. Good, awesome. Wonderful. Gewas, hello, man. I'm so glad you've joined us. This is wonderful. Gonna make sure YouTube, I don't know if YouTube has a chat feature on it. OCO. So it looks like we're slowly getting everybody to join and all that good stuff. Connecticut is in the building. I'm just thrilled. I think we're all thrilled that we're able to do this. The technology is allowing us to be able to do this. Just so happy that you guys are here with us.
Hi, Jeannie.
I just want to give a special shout out to Blake Trueblood for using MySpace at the con. I didn't even know that we were on MySpace.
He's not.
I didn't know that MySpace had chat and had live streaming capabilities. But Blake, there's a new thing called Facebook. You might want to migrate over here sometime soon. Wind River, hey man, Howard Brown. I know that you know you DM'd me about the film and already some of the thoughts that you had about it. So I'm so happy for you to be here. And it looks like Blake is very happy to be on MySpace actually right now. Sean McCabe, what's up, my brother?
Seattle.
Lakota in Denver, Colorado, and Dakota. Welcome. I'm hoping YouTube might just only be able to like watch. That may be all that we can do with YouTube. We're on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram. You're probably only seeing this much of this right now. Let's just see if we can turn this to a LinkedIn view. We can't. But you're probably only getting this much of what's going on right now. And I will say that for the folks on Instagram, this is going to be pretty much an audio experience for you because everything is so vertical and the way the content is displayed. I'll let you know immediately after we show the film here in a second how that you can watch it in its entirety on YouTube here just momentarily. We're going to go live with the film right after we premiere it here, especially with you guys. Tohono O'odham, MHA, Mandan Hadassah Arikara, Southwest Wisconsin, Arizona, Ohio, Albuquerque, New Mexico, Scottsdale, Hollowessapony in North Carolina, North Kakalaka represent, Michigan. Just thank you guys so much for joining us. There's apparently some place in Nevada called Sin City. Not sure. That might be Las Vegas. Thank you for joining Nevada, Colorado, Seattle, Columbus, Ohio, Reno, Nevada. So thank you guys. Just going to give it a Coeur d'Alene Reservation, Seguin, Texas, Passamaquoddy, the people of the Dawn, Cuba, New Mexico, Spokane, Washington. Thank you guys for joining. More folks from Wind River, thank you for joining. Mika Leonard, Miami Tribe, representing from Denver. Denver.
Hi, Mika.
In the building. Hey, Mika. Can you guys say hello, Mika?
Hi, Mika.
Can you say hello, Olive?
Hi, Olive.
Hi, Olive.
There we go. We got the Seneca Nation here with us tonight. I just want to give it a few more seconds. We're 5 minutes in right now.
But if you pronounce the boys' names.
Yes, Jeannie, we can. So I'll let you guys introduce, starting from...
Oldest.
My name is Quana Davis, or Quana. Yeah. I don't know.
Both of those were right.
And you, sir?
My name is Sequoia.
Speak up, my guy.
My name is Sequoia.
Okay, Sequoia.
My name's Quinn.
But what's your real name?
Quinucia.
Where's Cliff?
And right here, where's he at?
Up there.
Oh, Mr. Clifton Cottrell, OCO, my brother. Carmen?
Yes, my name is Carmen.
There you go. We just covered that twice.
Okay.
So just want to say we just got back last night at about midnight from Hollywood, from Los Angeles, California, where we premiered the film there, and it was wonderful. It was the first time I'd actually seen the film on the big screen. We'd never seen it that, you know, the way that it would be presented in the movie theater, and it was just amazing. It was wonderful to be able to share it there with people in person. The reception was just beautiful, man. It was, you know, I don't know if you want to share any of your thoughts about this weekend.
It was amazing to have, well, I think to back up, the short film has been done for over a year. And so for us, you know, it's done the festival circuit, pretty much since it was completed. And so for us, we've kind of been holding on to it. So to be able to see it on the big screen, to be able to now share it with you guys, I'm really excited because just it's awesome to finally get it out into the world. And the comments from last night, it was just amazing. And so we appreciate everybody's feedback in the comments, and we hope you all enjoy it as well.
Absolutely. And what'd you guys think about it?
Good. Emotional.
I will say, every time that I still watch it, you know, whenever it's come up that I'm getting ready to send it someplace, or even though it's been a year since we've had it completed, I still can't barely watch it without choking up. I know I was sitting 3 seats away from him and he got emotional again, and he kept looking at me to see if I was getting emotional, to decide if he was going to get emotional. And so I was trying to hold it together. I'm just so happy that this night has come and that we have the opportunity through technology to be able to share it with all of you and for you to be able to see it with us. Mm-hmm. And that we have an opportunity afterwards to have a bit of dialogue and to see how it's impacted you and what your takeaways from it were. Yesterday was the day after the screening in Hollywood, and we were in just kind of decompressing from everything. And somebody asked me who I was going to sell this film to. And quite honestly, I'm not interested in selling this film. I want it to be for you. I want people to be able to watch it whenever they want to watch it, have access to it whenever they want to see it. Because I think my hope is that it will have a resonation throughout Indian country to reach people. And it's just 11 and a half minutes. It's not very long at all, but there's a lot packed in it. And a lot of emotion that I think the saying of what's personal is universal, absolutely, I hope holds true here. And so far it's been that. It's been accepted at 16 different festivals, from Amsterdam to Berlin, to Black Hills Film Festival, to Manhattan Film Festival, to just this past weekend in Hollywood, and several other film festivals. It's won two awards, actually three. And so we're very happy that it's had that kind of an impact already. It's been tough, like Carmen said, holding on to it for all this time, especially while it makes its way across the country. And we're 10 minutes in. I don't want to waste anybody's time. I know that we're getting ready to get into the holidays, and we're not cooking here for this holiday that's coming up. We refer to it as Turkey Day. Maybe some of you are already with family and have people that you're with. So
we
want to get to it.
Yet.
Yeah, we're not cooking yet. As a matter of fact, I don't even think we know what we're going to have for dinner, if we could go that far. But anyway, I just want to say thank you guys for joining us. We're going to, at this point, show the film. And anything else you guys want to add? Anything else?
Nope.
Nebraska, I've been seeing you guys weighing in. So what I'm going to do just for a second is I'm going to move the chat off of the screen. And we're going to set it up here so that when it plays, that it'll be able to play full screen. And with that said, I'm going to have us go dark. And then we'll play the film. So I hope you enjoy it. And right afterwards, we'll be back. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to present to you Strong Hearts, an Indigenous love letter to my sons.
I love you. As I say those words in my head and think of you, it almost makes me cry. The miracle that you are, the love that you were conceived in, all that you mean to me could never be fully expressed with words. My love for you encompasses all. The moment you were born, I was filled with such an overwhelming appreciation to the Creator for blessing us with the miracle of your life. I was thankful for you, that you were healthy. You were all I had hoped you would be, and a million times more. I marveled at you. It was at that moment that I began to understand the true meaning of unconditional love. Because of you, my life changed forever. I was filled with a sense of responsibility and duty to you, to our family. I was on a mission to be the best provider that I could be. A good portion of my childhood was filled with dysfunction, struggle, and instability. I knew I didn't want that for you. I wanted you to know the opposite of all of that. Love and stability, peace and structure. I wanted you to have a home where you could thrive and grow, that wouldn't be here one day and gone the next. There are far too many broken Indigenous homes, the end game of colonization, oppression, and decades of failed U.S. policies. I don't know that I knew it by name at the time, but I wanted to end generational trauma and instability, starting with our little family. I often think of the hundreds of Indigenous children who never got the opportunity to live their lives, who were cut down by U.S. cavalry charges, disease, or that disappeared at Indian boarding schools, never to be seen again. We must always remember them and do all we can with our lives so that they can live through us. Be proud of who you are as an Indigenous person. Never let someone's lack of knowledge about you make you feel inadequate. Grow your hair, sing your songs, participate in your ceremonies. When we do these things, our people continue to live. Our ways are as old as the dirt. Our culture ties your spirit to the Creator, to your people, and to all those that have walked this earth before you. Through the Creator, you are connected to a power that is beyond this earth. Be proud of everything that makes you who you are. Know your value and your worth. You are a blessing. You are from the Creator. This land, it is your land. It is beautiful. It is our place of worship. It is a constant reminder of the magnificence of the Creator. It is healing, energy, and sustenance. It holds the power of our ancestors. Mother Earth is always there to recharge your spirit. Be still. Be present. When you need answers, wherever you are never alone. The Creator is everywhere. The Creator is in you. I remember the night at dinner when we talked about what you learned at school. It was November, Native American Heritage Month. You told us you learned about Chief Joseph, Sitting Bull, and Crazy Horse. And then out of nowhere, you began to sob. It was an anguished cry, a lament that I had not heard come out of you until that moment. The questions you asked through your tears were beyond heart-wrenching to your mother and I. Why did they do that to them? Why didn't they just leave them alone? Why did they kill him? That night I watched as a part of your innocence was replaced with righteous condemnation. You asked rational questions that anyone would ask when learning about the lives of these strong indigenous men and their people. Ultimately, the answer is unfortunately as heinous as the atrocities committed against them so long ago. The wounds still remain open. The irreparable cost that has been paid by our ancestors lingers to this day. The opportunities I have today have been afforded me by indigenous men and women who fought and resisted on battlegrounds all across this country that most in America know little to nothing about. Since the active, overt military campaigns against tribes and our people across North America came to an end, a slow and systematic erasure of indigenous people has continued. It is the ultimate spinning of a narrative to serve an unrelenting thirst for money and land at the cost of exterminating parts of or whole tribal nations in the process. Stereotypes, misconceptions, and caricatures continue to portray Native people in a damaging and disrespectful manner. These covert weapons ultimately reduce the complex history of tribal, historical, and personal experiences into nothing more than desensitized, single-faceted representations. We are not honored by your mascots, your products, or your good intentions. There is either reciprocity, or there is not. The Creator makes no mistakes. We all have a purpose that we are born to accomplish. So never let others limit or define your purpose or possibilities. The greatness of the Creator is inside of you, and what the Creator has for you, no man can stop. But that doesn't mean they won't try. Don't let their words discourage you. Don't let their insecurity stifle your growth. In 1877, when the Oglala Lakota chief Crazy Horse was forced to surrender at Fort Robinson, Nebraska, because the U.S. government had slaughtered tens of thousands of buffaloes on purpose, causing his people to face starvation, he was met with a hero's welcome. This, and his reception by military leaders at the fort, made some of the other chiefs very jealous of him. They feared that his popularity would cause him to be seen as the obvious leader of the Lakotas and that their long-standing positions would be diminished. Through rumor, innuendo, and blatant lies, these leaders and their cohorts became complicit in an escalation of events that led to Crazy Horse being bayoneted in the back and killed. A great man killed by a much lesser man. Always pay attention to what is going on around you, my son. Pay attention to what people do more than what they say. It is often the ones closest to you that stand to cause you the most harm. Pay attention to who is not clapping when good things happen to you. And in that moment when someone shows you how they are, you owe it to yourself to believe them. then conduct yourself accordingly. Pray. As the Creator brings blessings your way, stay humble and never forget who you are. Never forget where you get your strength. Help other people and be compassionate. Treat people how you would want to be treated. It's not weak to be kind, even though some people may view it that way. Be a good man and honor the Creator, for nothing is greater than that. Nothing. Never be afraid to do what is right. I love your mother. I love her spirit, her strength, her smile, her eyes. She is beautiful. My grandmother, my mother, my sister, the amazing women who have taken me as their son, I am more because of all of them. You're blessed to have so many strong Indigenous women in your life. Treat your wife with respect, love, and compassion, the way you have seen done. Your children will learn from your example, and they will do as you have done. For as long as I am able, I will be there to lift you up, share with you what I know, pray for you, and love you with all that I am. I will walk with you as long as I can, but time stops for no one. Be bold, be brave, and go not where the whims of people would take you, but follow instead where the Creator leads you. Move with intention, knowing you are never alone. Weak hearts and cowards to the rear. Strong hearts to the front. I love you.
Wow. That was Strong Hearts, an Indigenous love letter to my sons. And haven't had to this moment that I've ever watched it yet not impact me. And I've seen it so many times. I think the film means So many things to me, personally. When I was writing it, I couldn't help but think about not just the things my family has gone through, but I've had a pretty unique journey, having met so many people across Indian country that are more like family than they are like anything else, and who shared with me their stories. And I think when I was writing this, a lot of that came out. And also, you know, thinking about people who we won't ever be able to comprehend their sacrifice and what they went through and how much we still have to fight against every single day to be seen and heard and be visible. And I don't know that I'll live enough years to be able to truly have the impact that I ultimately would want to have to see that would all be eradicated. But if I was to have a moment to share with my sons some of the things that they would be able to take with them as they traveled in their journey, in their life, to remember to watch how people act, watch what people do, listen more to what people do than what they say, to always know that you're never alone, that you always have the Creator. And so many of the clips in the film are me with them, almost as if I'm not there, because I think that's ultimately the thing that I wanted to impress upon them, is that while I'm going to ride with you every single second of my life, and even the scenes with Quanah, with each of them, it's that they're there in the moment. I'm almost not there, but that they can feel me. And, you know, I would have people tell me, well, you know, why don't you do a cutaway to this when you talk about the boarding school and bring the images in? And it's, you know, I don't think they completely understood that it's about the power of the words that are spoken and the visuals. And I don't know if a lot of you even know that in this film that you just saw, all of the places that we shot are places where Crazy Horse fought. It was the greasy grass, what most people would know as the Battle of the Little Bighorn, not very far from there, just south and east of there is another place at the end of Rosebud Creek that is a place called the Battle of the Rosebud, where thousands of Lakota, Dakota, Nakota, and Cheyenne warriors fought General Crook and so decisively beat him back that he had to turn around and go back to Wyoming. And we shot it at Pine Ridge in South Dakota, and we shot it at Fort Robinson, Nebraska, where Crazy Horse was murdered by a man who'd been in the military for forever, never rose above the rank of private, and took his life, who mysteriously 1 year later, not even 1 year, died of an asthma attack. Crazy Horse has meant so much to me in my journey, because he was often misunderstood, even by his own people. He was, in the film, it talks about lateral oppression. Our people still go through that and are still dealing with it on a daily and weekly and monthly and yearly basis, because that's one of the byproducts of oppression. But he had that then. And the people that were jealous of him and the people that were envious of him. And so many people don't know his story, but he sort of personifies the struggle that we have as a people, in that he was literally shot in the face over someone, something, you know, that he was following his heart with a woman that he loved, and jealousy again. And ultimately what killed him is the evilness of some of his own people. And yet he knew what was coming for him. So at the end of the day, there's so much underlying current in this film that I just want to make sure that you have access to it. And I think I'll digress. And obviously, Carmen, executive produced. We started IndigiStudios. We have many other films that we want to make. And we will make. One is a script that I've just finished writing that we'll be taking out now. And of course, Carmen and I will be producing, and I will be morphing more into directing and writing, but I'll still be acting. And at the end of the day, I think I'll digress as much as of a synopsis that I've just given about the film. It's so much more, and I hope that it means whatever it means to you. And to your families, because one of the main things that I've also wanted it to be is for as many broken homes as we have across Indian country, and how hard it's been for fathers and for men to be able to find their place because of what has been ripped from us, our dignity, our pride, who we are as, you know, as men. And the way that that has negatively impacted the community because of those things that were done, that generational trauma that we inherit through DNA and through that legacy that is not anything to do with our community or our people, that it would be there for them to say to their sons or to show to their sons, or for sons who haven't a father, that they would be able to watch this and know that they're loved. And that they matter. So with that, I'm going to let you speak a little bit.
I'm going to try to hold it together. But I think this was so meaningful on so many different levels, and all of the reasons why you just touched on. But as a husband and wife team, it was really meaningful for this to be our first project of this new company, because it is so meaningful, and because our family has been so intertwined in everything that we have done and everything that we continue to do. And that's at the core of everything. And so, and for the reasons of addressing the historical trauma, for addressing the boarding schools, for addressing all of the pain that our people have had to endure. And at the same time, that it still affects us to this day. It still affects us in so many ways. And it's meaningful because Gary and I, we're not perfect. Nobody's perfect. But we try our best to fight for our family and to continue to break those cycles every single day. And those are many different cycles. And so to see just this unfold as it has, it's obviously extremely meaningful for our family, and for me as a mother to see my husband express that about my children and about our sons. It just is very meaningful, and I feel like because of what has happened in the historical trauma, and our kinship system has been dismantled, And whether that's from boarding schools and that's stealing our children away and putting them, spreading them apart and dividing them to where they felt alone. They were all of the things that happened in those boarding schools. And it's something that we do deal with every single day. And Indigenous families deal with that. And, to fill those voids, there's alcoholism, there's drug abuse, there's suicides, and there's all of the ills that plague our community. And at the same time, we have, through prayer and through conscious healing, we have the power to reclaim who we are and to reclaim our families and to reclaim those kinship systems and to ultimately provide a stronger foundation for our future generations.
Thoughts? Comments? This is the silent majority here, apparently. The film, let me just double check something here really quick. But I believe the film is available for you. Let me just double check. It still shows that I'm live. But I believe if you go to youtube.com/Litefoot, you should be able to see the film right at the top of the page. And please watch it, share it, send it to whomever you think should see it. It's free. Use it, for yourself, for others, let people see it. And, I think that this is very much so where I am at in my career, in my life, and, obviously have responsibilities and I have a leadership position still and nothing to take away from that or I've fully committed to all of that, but I also understand that I have other ways to be able to help move this forward and to reclaim the narrative, which is the mantra of IndigiStudios. Through that, Carmen and I and our family, in whatever ways that we can, will continue to attempt to make more expeditious change through media and film and reaching people worldwide and globally through media and entertainment to be able to impact people in a more effective and efficient way so that our time is best spent and most impactful. So with that, I know I've been seeing chats come in. I think I saw how much is the film cost or how much do I have to pay to watch? You don't have to pay anything. It is available right now at youtube.com/Litefoot. I obviously can't say enough about how proud I am of these guys. Today, Quana just did something right before we actually went live here that is just made me even more proud of all the things that he's already done at this point, which, is just a front row seat to watching the evolution of where these guys are going in their own journeys and all that good stuff. And this guy, just kind of getting going, especially you, but earning it every single day, right? Yeah? No?
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Pascal, thank you. Glad that you could join us. It's over now, Pascal. I'm glad you could make it. I think that leads me to a very important thing. And again, a little bit of behind the scenes here. This was shot literally the day that Quana and I got out of Sundance in Wyoming. It was Quana's third dance, right?
Mm-hmm.
and it was my seventh dance. And literally the next day, where that we got out on Monday, we drove to, from Wind River, we drove to, where did we pick everybody up? Pascal,
Casper.
Can you?
Casper?
No, you sure? Anyway, we drove someplace in Wyoming that has an airport. and we picked up the crew. We drove all the way to Montana to Hardin. Mm-hmm. We stayed in Hardin, Montana, and the next morning we shot at there at Crow Agency on the greasy grass, the little bighorn site. We then left there, drove down to the Rosebud. We shot all of the scenes there. We then left and drove down through Wyoming and shot at a couple of other places, Battle of the Hundred in the Hand. Pascal said it was the Hair Care and Tire Center Airport. Thank you for reminding me of that. And we then drove all the way that night to Rapid City.
Uh-huh.
We slept for a few hours. Mm-hmm. We got up the next morning. We shot on Pine Ridge, and we then moved down and shot at Fort Robinson. Correct? Yes.
Yep.
Carmen. Yeah. A little affirmative. yes, you did.
Yes.
I think yes. So it was a two-day shoot. Two-day shoot. And the next day, and after we shot at Fort Robinson, we drove to Denver, slept mm-hmm. for a few hours, got up on a plane, and returned to Dallas. So
you're forgetting the Badlands.
Well, the Badlands were at Pine Ridge.
Oh yeah,
So anyway, it was a 2-day shoot, and so I want to say thank you to Carmen for organizing, because while we were in Sundance for 3 days, Carmen was wrapping up all the final details, totally executive producing the whole thing, while also supporting us on the inside and watching these guys do whatever they do. And then Pascal Quack, who just I was referring to, did all the drone photography and captured some amazing sequences there. An amazing member of my own tribe, Jeremy Charles, did the DP work. He was director of photography, and just so proud that the Indigenous representation on this project, obviously with these guys and with Jeremy and myself and with Carmen. And we shot it in a really quick fashion to get all that stuff out. So just want to say thank you, guys. Don't want to bore you with too much of the details, but it was definitely something that had a lot of energy while we were shooting it. And one thing that I will say, some of the stuff that we shot, having the sun, because of the fires that were happening mm-hmm. all over the plains, while we were in Sundance, we didn't know what that impact would be to the shoot. And as we got up into that whole area, there was this filter sort of across the sky that held for both of the days that we shot through that whole region. So there was continuity between what we were shooting, and it allowed us to really pan up and shoot into the sky and capture the sun. The last shot of the film, where there's a slow pan up to the boys that was shot at the Rosebud battlefield, and the sun is right there, and it's just a total gift from the creator to have that kind of a lighting package that nobody could ever afford in the world. And so I think it really helped set the tone thematically, visually for the film. So anyway, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for taking the time tonight and for, sharing this time with us and sharing this moment. We've been on here for about 45 minutes. I think basically if there's maybe like 5 questions, if anybody has any questions, or we'll do our best to try to read them and answer anything that you guys might have before we jump off of here and figure out what we're going to have for dinner. You're very welcome. All of the thank yous. thank you for all the memories that you guys are sharing. And Margaret, it's a blessing to have crossed your path. And thank you for your good words. Thank you for all the comments.
Are you coming out Chris, with a new rap song?
Oh.
When is your new CD coming again?
So this guy, in addition to being a model, and modeling and acting, he's doing some things right now, but he's also, I think would you say your heart is in music? You know, there's sound.
You can speak.
This isn't a silent movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, I'm sorry, my bad. Anyway, who asked me about, long story short, the music, this guy is producing now, and it's just a beautiful thing to full circle come back to create my last album that he produces, and really do something epic, something that will resonate. I feel like my catalog at this point is a pretty strong catalog. And I don't want to do anything that's like, okay, well, you should have stopped at the last one. You might want to help back on the left. So this one's got to definitely be very impactful. We have a documentary that we're getting ready to do, a couple of documentaries actually, that are in one's in post-production, one's in pre-production. And this guy is doing the soundtrack on the one that's in post-production right now. So I look forward to at least doing that soundtrack and potentially doing one more album. I also, and I think this is, you know, these guys play lacrosse almost every single day of their life. And so it's hard because I want to be there for them. But we are kicking around going back on tour for some short runs to do some concerts and to remind folks the energy of what me performing live, and to remind myself what the energy of me performing live does.
So I think there was more questions up there. Joe said, what was your favorite shot?
Joe,
Mr. Joe Sarsinella, what was your favorite shot?
I think the shots of Carmen, you know, of course I have to trust Carmen right now because I'm not stupid.
That was like such a setup. That's not.
Thank you, Joe. I'll please send me that the bill for that question.
Okay.
No, but I think that it was just so many things that happened that we didn't do, and the way that the sky looked, the coloring that came out of all of that, the wind was just blowing enough to give her that Beyonce moment. and you know, I think one of the shots that happened so naturally because the narration was actually written after we shot everything. The visuals really helped me write this, and there's a moment that happened almost just, I couldn't have planned it. The part where he's telling me, which he really did, he literally sitting in there at our table, came home from school, and we were all eating, we were having a conversation, and he just lost it because they were studying about Crazy Horse and who? Sitting Bull?
Sitting Bull, Chief Joseph, and I think Geronimo.
And they got into some stuff at school that day, and he was just very distraught. And man, I think it even ended with me reading him Chief Joseph's statement, mm-hmm. That is his most famous statement.
Which then I was crying.
Then everybody's crying, and then we're like, wow, I just thought we were going to eat dinner tonight. and so it really hit me that it hit him that hard, and that, you know, as a father, as much as you try to shield them from the realities of this world and the history and what's happened, and you just keep moving forward, it hit him. And it hit him so hard that it hit us out of the blue that it was happening in that moment. And so when I wrote it and I laid that footage over the top of that narration, it was almost as if he was hearing it as we were doing it and reacting to it. Mm-hmm. And that, I thought, Joe, to answer your question, was probably one of the most powerful pieces in the whole piece, because it just happened as if it was so meant to be. And it was just like dropping that perfect piece to fill that gap so perfectly. And to really hit that moment. And I think all of that, it's the creator. It's just meant to be. And it's just getting in that wave and following that wave and letting it take you where it's supposed to go. So,
Pascal said,
where's this?
How was the emotional experience on site?
He was there.
Yeah, Pascal. You were there. Why don't you? I do want to say at the end, you know, because this is so, it's intense. It gets into a lot of stuff. It's my hope for their future. It's on so many different layers, so many different things. At the very end, this guy, who's known for his breaking up a moment, as you might start to see here in a second, they didn't know the camera was still rolling. And he goes over and gooses him. And then he turns around because he knows, well, you know, you little sucker. Let me, you know, then he sees that and sees him as the new target and goes over to try to goose him. And then you see my foot step in. I thought that was such a fatherly sort of a thing where they're acting up. And then you just see my foot step into frame. And then they're like, oh, wait. I thought that was a pretty great moment because it shows truly in their spirit. And then at the end, the shot of us as a family out there. I thought that those were great sort of energies to also put into this, because, you know, it's not like, you know, that's how we walk around all day long is just totally in that zone. We're a family. We live, we love, we have emotions. We're not perfect. We, you know, argue, these guys argue, we get into it just like everybody, you know, I mean, there's no perfect anything. But we love each other and we're a family, and that's the main thing. And we move forward. And so thank you for that question, Pascal. And,
somebody said, how can I get one of your Native Honey shirts?
You can go to nativestyleclothing.com. And will you be filming Cherokee storylines at some point? Do you see making features or documentaries being in the forefront?
Absolutely.
Features, absolutely. Absolutely. I feel like I can do both. I feel like I want to do both. I'm already doing documentaries. This technically didn't exist as a documentary when I started out, but I guess that's technically what it would be labeled, and there's kind of fell into that thing, but there's definitely some other documentaries we want to do. But features, the thing I just wrote is absolutely a feature, and so I look forward to writing, you know, not just writing it but directing it as well. Looking forward to Quanah's movement. Yes, I think we all are. Quanah, did you see this? Did you say thank you?
Oh, thank you. Me too.
Quanah says that he's looking forward to his movement too.
Thank you.
Thank you for the good wishes. Could you feel the ancestors during the filming? Very powerful film. Again, I think the just the vibe, and Pascal, maybe this is what you were getting at, the energy that was there, the way that things were coming together, that whole scene in the Badlands, where we shot that with the drones and Quanah was standing up on the edge there of that huge drop off. We were driving into Pine Ridge, and what happened?
You said, let's turn around right here. Or you said, hold on, let's go in right here. And it was just such a very...
But you couldn't see any of that.
No,
it just looked like a field.
And there were no signs right there either. It was just a roadway.
So we came upon that whole thing very organically. So yes, I do feel, especially coming out of Sundance, that we were just flowing. And I know Jeremy was asking me, okay, so what is exactly that we're going to shoot? And I said, just trust me. And he's like, okay, bro, we're here. Let's go do it and let's rock. And Jeremy's a wonderful man. He's so awesome. His energy was the perfect energy. And we just... Shooting at Fort Robinson, where Crazy Horse died, and I don't know if you know this or not, but right where that monument is, and it pans up, and you see that building, that is the jail that they tried to put Crazy Horse Inn, and he literally was bayoneted right in front of that building. And he fell there, and then he was moved down to some buildings that are not there anymore. And he was brought inside and laid on the floor of an officer's building there. But being there in that moment, his medicine was, one of his medicines was a hawk. And there was a hawk that flew right over when we were filming. And that's why I put it in the film, and you can see it. I just happened to turn around and catch it as it flew by. And that's why I inserted it into that moment there with him when they're talking about him. But I think that was really, really heavy, and it was really, really powerful. And it was really crazy because the people at Fort Robinson and the historical site that it is came, and they were like, do you want to go into the buildings? Uh-huh. Do you want to shoot in here? And literally the way that we ended up in some of those buildings where there's President Grant and there's those tables, those were some of the things that were inside the building that were locked up that you could only see through the window. So we had access to some of the stuff there that totally wasn't planned, that just happened. So yes, I definitely think the creator was doing a lot of location scouting for us. And that energy, absolutely, I have to give all of this to the creator and that energy. So yes, I absolutely think that. How long did it take to make the short film? It took me 2 days, two days mm-hmm. total to shoot it. And how long did it take me to edit it? I edited it, scored it,
I think,
and colored it.
A week.
So it took a week and 2 days.
Yeah.
And then I submitted it to the first festival. People are liking your Beyonce moment there, Carmen.
Someone said let the older boy speak.
Where is this?
It's right there. Let the old man.
I'd love for the older boy to speak.
All right. Something that no one knows about is that when we were in the Badlands, I almost fell in the cliff, the cavern.
Wait, what?
And at the last minute, my dad took out his hand and I grabbed it and he pulled me out.
That's such a lie. Really? Well, okay, let's go with that. Sure, that happened.
You're capping.
But that was gold. That cap. Was gold.
Cap. So the older boy spoke. Has the older boy got anything else that he'd like to say?
Well, so my room is right across from where my dad works. Like, his office is here. My room is down there. I don't know if that's a leak. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that.
No, you can say that.
Yeah.
Okay. But I, for like a year straight, I would hear him working on this every single night for so long, and just to see it finally come out, I'm just proud of him, and I'm just grateful that, hopefully, like my kids can see that, and, I'm just very proud that it's finally out.
Thank you.
What about you, Sequoia? Mm-hmm. You've been a little bit quiet too.
How about you?
I think it's a great film. Pretty emotional. And it's pretty cool.
Pretty cool. Is that all you have to say?
Well, why don't you say what you have to say? Pascal said it was emotional for him, too.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
What Kwan said.
No, that's not going to cut it.
Okay.
We're missing a lot of questions.
Yeah.
We're spending like 20 minutes on questions.
How about you scroll it down?
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Wait, look.
Here's my friend from high school and his family. Sitting and watching with his wife, and he's not actually typing this. His wife is, because I don't know if he knows how to use the internet at all. And so he wants to know why the scene with him didn't make the final cut. That is in the bloopers that will come out. I don't know that there are bloopers to this, but we're going to file it under that. So I'll let you know when that makes it to YouTube. It might just be a little clip that I sent to you for your phone. So, well, you don't know how to use your phone either. love you guys, man. Well, yeah, and man, we well, here's one thing that I will say, and this is something that Pascal and all these, you know, the crew that was with us, when we left Fort Robinson. And for those of you who don't know much about Crazy Horse, and for those of you who do, you'll understand this. He was blessed by the Wakanyans and the Thunder Beings. And when we left Fort Robinson, it was a beautiful day. I mean, you saw the sky. By the time that we left there that night, the thunder and the lightning... it was just, it enveloped us. And for a good portion of the drive to Denver, it was pouring. Mm-hmm. And the thunder and the lightning. And I just took that as such a affirmation of the spirits knowing that we were there and what we were doing. And it was just a huge blessing and just... a lot of prayer, a lot of praying, and just gratefulness and gratitude and humility that happened right in that moment. So, you know, this is before anything. So I just can't communicate enough how grateful I am and how all of this has to be shared and given credit to the Creator and to all of our relatives and our ancestors that put that energy into this. And before we even knew how it was going to be edited, or what the music was going to be, or what the narration was going to be. And all of that came in to play here. So, yeah, it was powerful.
Somebody said nativestyle.com. It's Native Style Clothing.
Yeah, nativestyleclothing.com.
Yes.
Nativestyleclothing.com. And that's why Pascal asked if we're having Chick-fil-A for dinner, because literally we were so starving because we'd been working on the film all day long and we're trying to get to Denver. We finally stopped at some place and got Chick-fil-A.
Mm-hmm.
And that was dinner that night, but I think it was dinner at least, was it?
Is that or Subway?
Yeah, it was either that or eating at Starbucks, which is always...
Subway?
Yeah, there you go. Brad Bauman, thank you so much, man. I hope you and the family are well, and thank you for coming and watching this with us tonight. Thank you for all the love. I just watched the video. I am crying. It was so beautiful. I will sit down and have my two kids watch this. This is what needs to be said to our Native children and non-Native children as well. We all need to hear those words and feel those words. Absolutely powerful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So you're being requested to come home to the Macaw Reservation.
Yay, we're going to be there already.
and we will get them back there.
Yes.
They for sure have been there. And just want to say, well, that's your family, so do you want
to... No, just shout out to everybody in Nia Bay. And we definitely will be back home soon.
Let's see... What about all the rattlesnakes in the grass? We had no snakes.
Oh, no!
Not that we literally didn't go traipsing right out into these fields.
Well, wait, he's got something.
Go ahead.
Although, we did find shedding from snakes.
Yeah.
Skins.
Yeah.
Whatever you want to call them.
But we were fortunately taken care of. Let's see. Before we wrap up and jump off of here, we're coming up to 4 minutes past the hour.
Okay.
What a legacy from a father to family. You truly inspired me as a father to be the best I could be for my daughters, grandkids, and my family. Thank you. No, thank you. Somebody asked who I was, and I was just introduced as Little Bear. Well, there you go.
I love it.
That's awesome. And let's see. Chimiguech. The train and thunderstorm was a cleansing from the ancestors. The ancestors are with you all the time. The strength behind your movements. Thank you. Beautiful family. Continued to success. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of it. Your family has touched me in so many ways, but this experience was deep. Well, Pascal, thank you for everything, and we thank you for being a part of this. Sean McCabe, my brother, thank you for the gift you've given us. And your family, much love to all of you. Love to you, man. So listen, I'm going to go ahead and sign off. We're going to get these guys some food. It's been a long weekend and then a long first day back with their activities and everything else that we've had today. This, I hope, again, has been wonderful for you. Thank you for joining us, for tuning in. Strong hearts and Indigenous love letter to my sons. It is now yours to watch, to share. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn.
All the socials.
All the socials. And stay tuned for more to come very soon. You don't have any socials, my guy. Sorry.
I'm Instagram.
Oh, yeah. You know what? These guys do have Instagram. He's got Instagram. Quana.
Quana Davis 11.
Quana 11. Right?
Quana Davis 11. It's not Quana Davis. It's Quana Davis 11.
That's a whole other conversation. Let's make it as complicated as possible.
Sequoia Davis.
Sequoia.
And Quinusia.
Sequoia _ Davis. Quinusia, Q-W-N-U-S-E-I-A, the football and lacrosse, and lacrosse and football, and music and modeling.
Workout.
This guy, workout. This is him. And then Carmen, Carmen Davis.
Yes.
And Carmen Davis. Yes. So thank you guys. Mika, thank you. Thank everyone for joining us tonight. We're going to sign off. And do you have anything else to say?
TikTok.
I don't have a TikTok, but I have a TikTok that I'm hardly never on. But we are going to start putting some content on TikTok. Which
Quana has TikTok.
Yeah, Quana has TikTok.
What is it?
It's Quana Davis, QUANNAHDAVIS, and there's a bunch of workout videos on there.
So basically, just Quana Davis.
And it says, Carmen, you never age. And that's because she's so pampered. She never touches the ground. She just floats around the house. And then has this beautiful wind that comes and blows through her hair.
I get it from my mama.
Yeah, there you go. She get it from her mama. She woke up like that. And if anybody ever sees Blake Trueblood, let him know how to get out of MySpace and get him a Facebook page. Thank you guys. The film is at youtube.com/LITEFOOT. youtube.com/LITEFOOT. And that is where the film is for you. Share it. Please share it on Facebook. Share it with whomever, wherever. And thank you so much for everybody tuning in. We appreciate it. And you guys have a great night. And we'll see you again soon. We'll do more live streams here in the future. But for now, have a great night. Blessings. Thank you guys tuning in from everywhere that you did.
Thank you.